The reason I wanted to learn how to code was simple. I wanted to build useful things and have those powerful tools right at my fingertips. More specifically, I wanted to build a cosmetics analysis app that can help find dupes for expensive products. I used to work in the beauty industry, and let's be real, most high-end products are just marketing gimmicks with fancy packaging and a hefty price tag. And I've always been into 3D. I believe 3D websites are the future, and I wanted to learn how to make them. But what really gave me the final push to start coding was the launch of ChatGPT-3, and it was like the perfect teacher because you don't need to worry about asking dumb questions. You can always ask it to break things down for you. So it all started with this book, Head First, HTML and CSS. If you've never seen it before, it's one of the most beginner-friendly books out there. Lots of visuals, exercises, and their humor is a big plus. You don't feel the pain of learning at all. Since HTML and CSS aren't programming languages, learning them is kind of like making a doll and dressing it up in fancy clothes. Sure, it looks great, but it just stands there doing nothing. That's where JavaScript comes in. So I also picked up the JavaScript book from Head First, but the version wasn't really up to date, and I had less fun with this book than the HTML CSS one, so I started to browse online materials. Knowing some bare minimum, I started to follow Brad Traversy and Florin Pop's 50 Projects in 50 Days JavaScript course. It was like watching him code, and he codes really fast. As a beginner in JavaScript, I just struggled to follow, and nothing really went into my brain. But later, I decided to remake each of the projects and added some creativity into it, and let me tell you, that was a game changer. Since I started to think like a problem solver, like how can I make this move like this, how to make it look better, how do I make it useful. But in the real world, most projects aren't built with vanilla JavaScript. They use frameworks. So after making 13 projects, I stopped the course. And as you can see, the projects are mainly front-end oriented. No database, no backend. At one point, I felt lost. JavaScript was overwhelming, and I wasn't sure what to do next. That's when I found Super Simple Dev on YouTube. At the time, he had only uploaded 2 episodes of his JavaScript course, but man, his teaching style was gold. His calming voice and his patient and slow explanation of each step about what he's doing, his design of exercises really helped me a lot. And if you want to learn JavaScript, just go and watch his course. I believe now he has more content to follow. After JavaScript, I thought I was ready for 3D web development. I was browsing 3D related content on YouTube, and I joined Wawa Sensei's community. He told me I have to learn some React to follow his content, so I decided to learn React as my framework. I read the official docs and tried making the tic-tac-toe game, but React Virtual DOM was confusing as hell. But by looking at other people's code, I began to understand how hooks work and how to pass the arguments down the component tree, how to manage states efficiently. And since React alone wasn't enough for bigger apps, I also got into Redux to manage global states. Originally, I had a co-founder for my cosmetics analysis app. The plan was I'd handle the front end, he'd take care of the back end, but he quit. So I had to take over. That's when I picked up Python. I started with, again, Head First Python book, but I only learned some basic grammar from it. I learned the most part of Python by looking at the code my ex-co-founder left me, and by breaking it, fixing it, and experimenting. We had 2 apps for the project, one for the user, one for the admins, and the admin system's backend was originally written in Java, and I had to convert it to Python. And that's when I discovered object-oriented programming, which I love so much because it brings order. And I'm glad I learned Python because AI is all about Python. Since our data is stored in Neo4j and MySQL, I had to learn to write queries. And trust me, you only really learn something when you are forced to use it. The more I coded, the more I realized the hardest part isn't the syntax. It's architecting a system properly, managing the data flow, structuring database efficiently. It's kind of like conducting an orchestra. AI tools can be helpful, but once your project scales and your database gets complex, you can't just rely on AI. Looking back, programming has been a wild ride, and I genuinely love it. I hope to keep building meaningful things like the cosmetics analysis app and the language learning app I'm working on right now. And if there's one thing I've learned, it's this: better done than perfect. This channel is here to document my journey, the wins, the struggles, the discoveries. So if you're also on this path, let's learn and grow together. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.